My name is Ashok Thapar. Today we are going to talk about what is marketing or an overview of marketing. We are going to discuss what is marketing, evolution of marketing, marketing philosophies, scope of marketing, the concept of exchange, the concept of value, and why do we need and why we should study this particular subject of marketing. First of all, let's understand what is marketing. If we ask this question, we get very different understanding about the subject. Some say that marketing is selling. Some say creating a wonderful copy or designing an excellent advertisement is marketing. Some say that creating a promotional campaign is marketing. Some say that doing the research is marketing. Some say that making the product available is marketing. Let me say that marketing is all that plus much more. We can say that marketing at its core is the process through which value is exchanged. Please understand, it is a process which facilitates exchange of value. Let's talk about, or let's take official definition of marketing, which is from AMA, American Marketing Association. The definition says that marketing is an organizational function and set of processes for creating, communicating, and delivering value to the customer. This used to be the focus or understanding of marketing maybe around 10 years back. But today, the definition emphasizes marketing is not only this, but also managing customer relationships in ways that benefit both organization and all the stakeholders. Please understand, this definition emphasizes that marketing is not a discipline. It is not an isolated department. It is the function of whole of the organization by which we create, communicate, and deliver the value to the customer and make a promise to the customer to deliver this value whenever they want it, wherever they want it. Also, establishing these customer relationship in a manner that both the seller and the buyer are happy, or all the stakeholders are happy. When we talk about the stakeholders, we are talking about the customers, we are talking about the employees, we are talking about the suppliers, we are talking about the banks, the investors, and society at large. What does this mean? It very clearly means that marketing is not a function, it is a way of doing business. It is the philosophy of a business, it is the attitude of a business. Today we go a step further and we say that whatever we do in the organization, if that influences the product preference of a customer, that we call as marketing. Anything that we do, if it makes my customers to buy my product or to prefer my product, that activity is termed as marketing. Let's understand, is it a science or is it an art? We would say that when we are doing market research, when we are trying to profile the customer, when we are trying to understand the customer profile, we will say that marketing is a very stringent science. But when I have this information with me, when I have this data with me, when I have done the market research, what do I do with that particular knowledge? Then we say marketing is an art. It's a very delicate, beautiful art. It's as delicate as writing a poetry, or scripting a film, or directing a film. Basically, what we say is marketing is a very creative activity. It's a very, very innovative activity. It is designing up those strategies which are as creative as, again I would say, writing a poetry. So we can say that marketing is a science and marketing is equally an art. Let's understand what are the components of marketing. Today we say that marketing is way of doing business. Marketing is a philosophy of an organization. Marketing is a perspective, an attitude, a culture of the organization. Plus these tactical decisions that we take in deciding the product, pricing, and maybe promotion and distribution strategy. This is what the marketing is all about. Let's understand what is meant by value, because we have been saying that facilitating the exchange of value is marketing. So let us understand what is value. Value can be termed as the ratio between perceived benefits divided by perceived cost. When I say perceived, it is individual's perception of the benefits. The benefits can be created in the tangible product attributes. The benefits could be created in the service by the addition of services. The benefits could be created by the personnel, or what we call as the people. And most important, the value is created, what we call as perceptive benefit, emotional benefit, which a customer feels. So the total customer benefits which are created in all these four areas divided by the perceived cost which a customer feels, which a customer evaluates that he is giving or sacrificing to get that benefit, the ratio of these is called as value. Please also understand, establishing this relationship or establishing the exchange relationship or wonderful relationship or happy relationship is marketing. The idea is the buyer and seller both should feel very happy with the transaction. The job of a marketing person or the job of marketing is to create this wonderful wow type of experience for the customer. That is what is important. It is not only that you have created the exchange, you got the money and the customer is not very happy. No, that is not marketing. Today we say that marketing establishes this wow type of experience for the customer, and the organization also is happy to have that exchange done. Let us understand what is meant by sales and marketing, or what is the difference between selling and marketing. We say that selling concept, the starting point of selling is the factory or the existing products. The focus is on the products, and the purpose of selling is to get these products removed or get these products shifted, exchanged. The end product, the end result that we expect from the sales is profit, but the profit through sales volume. We want to have more of sales and more of profit. That is what the selling concept is, and that is what the selling is all about. But when I talk about, or when you think about marketing, what are we saying is marketing, the starting point is market. Market means customer, their needs, their requirements. We start with that, and the focus of marketing is on the customer needs, their desires, their benefits. And here again, the objective is to get the profit, but to get the profit through, there is a mistake here, through customer satisfaction. The end is that we want to have a profit, and the marketing focuses on the profit, but through customer satisfaction. And that is the difference between selling and marketing. Why do we need to study marketing today? Why it has become so very important? Let's understand that the value can be created in any of the departments of the organization. It could be created in R&D, it could be created in any department, distribution, etc., etc. But this value can be exchanged only by the marketing department. Or the exchange could be facilitated only by the marketing processes, only by understanding the customer needs and giving them what they want. That is the reason it has become so very important for us to understand these processes, to understand what we call these philosophies, to understand this culture and create that value and create that exchange. That is the reason it has become so very important. Today we go and talk about that marketing strategy. No, we said marketing as a strategy for the organization, and that's the reason we need to understand, we need to study it. Thanks.